With sleepaway camps canceled and many day camps opening late, a new cottage industry is apparently all the rage now. CBS 2's Carolyn Gusoff reports from Long Island.
They're popping up across Long Island and beyond.
Everybody come here. We're going to split up into teams.
Backyard camps curing cabin fever for legions of kids. These quick-thinking high school seniors out of work as sleepaway counselors saw a need to fill as parents head to work.
Our camps has canceled. We need a job. And some people post on Facebook that I need babysitting, so we had the idea and kind of ran with it.
We have sports, arts and crafts. We can do some science experiments.
They're safe at home, earning high marks from 8 families who rotate backyards, each equipped with a watchful parent.
We have made sure there's enough parental supervision at all times. There's 2 counselors here today. My wife and myself are here, so it's pretty much 2-to-1 at all times.
It's a newly minted cottage industry with offerings across social media.
We can make a fun paint project.
Teacher Miss Alexa offers arts and crafts and enrichment.
It's back to the basics with good old-fashioned fun. I mean, playing tag, doing arts and crafts projects, some sports.
But turning your backyard into a pop-up camp comes with words of caution from this veteran.
There's a lot that goes into it that's got safety implications, and camps work all year long and train staff all year long to ensure that we can prevent, you know, things from going wrong.
What can go wrong? If you have a swimming pool, a whole lot, cautions Jay Jacobs, adding in allergies and bee stings. He advises parents to check references and ask who's supervising the counselors.
I personally would want to make sure that it has the permit from the health department and that it is licensed.
The Nassau County exec reminds parents camps are licensed with health and safety standards. A pop-up may not need a license to care for kids less than 3 hours a day, but attorney Ken Mollins reminds homeowners,
if something happens in your home, people are going to first look to the homeowner to see the coverage.
But given COVID risks, some see backyards as the safest option.
Sitting around the house and having the kids inside playing on their iPads for a summer without their friends is just not an option. There's a way to do this, and there's a way to do it healthily.
Grateful for young entrepreneurs salvaging summer. In Syosset, Long Island, Carolyn Gusoff, CBS 2 News.